everyone, welcome to my channel. I'm talking a bit difficult because I have butterflies glued to my face and I can't move my face too much, otherwise they'll fall off. But anyway, so yeah, this is today's look. It's obviously a special effects fantasy-ish look and I had a lot of fun creating it. I think it's a very good practicing method in painting detailed things on the face. So yeah, I really hope you'll enjoy watching it. By the way, if you want to see more of my makeup, you can always follow me on Instagram as well. I'll put my name down here. Yeah, where I share mostly a lot of makeup. So yeah, without further ado, let's get started. What I'm starting off with is simply putting scar wax over my eyebrows to block them out. Normally I would use a plastic knife for this purpose, but it's still in my makeup kit, which is currently behind my backdrop. So I just grabbed my trusty ruler instead. And also, if you don't have scar wax, you could use a glue stick for this, a water removable glue stick, obviously. Should be obvious at least. But yeah, I prefer scar wax just because I feel it's a bit more sturdy. Once my hairs are properly waxed, I'm just combing them upwards with a spoolie, which can be quite tough because at this point the hairs are already sort of sticky. This is going to look more than mildly weird, but it's just going to help everything to be as smooth as possible in the end. Once they're all sticking up, I'm just applying a second layer and I just realized that actually this is probably easier to like smear out with my fingers rather than a very big ruler. But do make sure on your fingers that are slightly oily with Vaseline or oil, obviously, just so it won't be as sticky. I'm just going to powder them off so my BB cream doesn't grab over it in a weird way. And yes, this is actually going to like be so much not fun to wash off later on. Actually, seeing as I'm going to use a BB cream and not an actual foundation, I'm going to apply a concealer over this first. If you're using a very high coverage foundation, you can obviously just use that and see how far that gets you. But yeah, because I want the rest of my skin to look quite natural, I do feel like I could use a little bit more coverage onto my brows. Just priming the eyelids now. I'm having technical issues. The on-off switch of the thing never actually did work properly. But anyway, I'm just priming my eyelids now and I'm mostly just focusing on the crease in the lid and I'm leaving the eyebrow-ish area alone. Then for the eyes, I'm just going to do a very quick and easy look with the Anastasia Beverly Hills Riviera Palette, which just arrived in the mail, which is quite surprising to me because according to the track and trace from the website where I bought it, it's still supposed to be in England at this point, but anyway. But yeah, it contains a lot of bright colors, so I feel like it's just going to suit well with the look. Decided to go for a pink, as you can see. I'm just going to put this all over my moving eyelids, and I'm really packing it on. I do want it to be there. I didn't use a setting spray or anything, because I don't want this to be, you know, like, this isn't going to be the eye catcher. That's the lamest word joke ever, I know, sorry. But I do want it to be there, obviously. Now I'm just blending it out with the pink shades that's a matte. So basically I'm just staying in the same color family, but moving on to a matte shade to define the crease a little bit more. And obviously I'm using a different brush for this. This is just a tiny blender, because with the other brush I would not be able to blend at all. I'm blending it out with a warmish nude shade. I am sticking quite close to the eye, just because I am going to apply, you know, like face paint and like paint a mask around it. So I do need enough space to do that. And if I were to do a very big eye look, I would just cover half of it with the face paint in the end, which would be rather a waste. So yeah, I'm sticking quite close to my eyeball. Then with a color that's pretty much my own skin color almost, I'm going around it again with a large fluffy blending brush, just to make sure everything is nice and smooth. Rosely, the inner corner highlight, I'm just doing that in white. And before I forget, I know myself after all, I'm going to just make my waterline nice and pale with a nude pencil. With everything is going to go around the eye later on, it is, I think, quite important to make your eye look nice and large, just because otherwise it's probably going to get quite lost within everything else in the end. Okay, I look more than mildly weird now, but at any rate, I'm just going to add concealer. How to create your own problems, I just did what I never do and applied this concealer all over my face, or at least where I want it to be, obviously. So now I gotta like blend really quickly, so I actually get it blended before it dries and doesn't budge anymore. Of course I'm also going to set it well. Then just quickly contouring. I'm using the Fembrush for everything, including my nose, just because most of this is going to be hidden behind the face paint and all anyway. Then a shimmery blush, sort of a natural shade. Then the highlight is going to go directly over that, and I'm going to keep it quite mild, for me at least, because again, most of it isn't going to be visible anymore in the end. I'm going to add some false lashes. In case you haven't noticed, I did not apply any eyeliner, so they're going to be quite natural lashes. But they're just going to give my lashes a bit more presence, to still make them stand out in the end. While the eyelash glue is drying, which takes approximately 5 years, I'm just going to already color my own lashes black with mascara. So what I'm going to do now is just make sure that my nude eye pencil is sharp, and I don't know if you can see actually, but I'm going to paint, or at least draw, the lines of what I want to do on my face already. Just makes it easier because, well, if I make a mistake with this I can still easily fix it, whereas if I do it with the face paint, it's going to be a whole lot harder. So yeah, just trying to make a sort of symmetrical butterfly-esque mask shape. I did draw it out on paper first, so I roughly know what I'm trying to accomplish at least, which is usually helps. And obviously you don't need to use a nude pencil for this specifically. Just use something that at least will not show up anymore once you apply the paint. So don't go for like bold black eyeliner, because that's not going to disappear enough. And then the bottom wing. I'm not going for a specific butterfly, by the way, because I don't know anything about butterflies, so I don't know any butterfly species. But yeah, this is just what we're going to roll with. Then I'm just going to add a little bit of a shadow below the mask before filling it in with a brown eyeshadow, just to make sure that it sort of looks as if it like lays on my face. One important thing is to just keep it one single light direction. My light comes from above, so I just made the shadows all to the downside. And then I'm just going to paint in the whole thing with purple face paint. I'm just using eyeshadow brushes for this, by the way. The face paint that I'm using is water activated, so it also washes off in water. Which is both nice for your face, but also for your makeup brushes, because at least in my experience, this won't ruin them. Now I'm just outlining everything. And I'm using a dark blue for that because I feel like black would be just a bit too strong. You can of course use an eyeliner brush for this. I'm using a striper just because I feel more confident with the striper. Actually meant for nail art. And just outline the entire thing. Okay, by this point it will probably feel like approximately half your life has been spent painting this thing. Let's hope it's worth it, but now I'm just going to use probably some green and orange to add some details, just like normal butterfly wings have. I'm going to use a eyeliner brush for that. So this is what my design looks like, and it's just basically a random collection of lots of dots. So yeah, basically you can do whatever you want. You can do dots, you can do heart shapes, you can do diamond shapes, whatever you want. Personally, I find dots quite easy, to be honest. So that's also partly why I chose dots, because I wanted it to look very neat and clean. So picking something that I would know that like that I know will work for me. Which is the easiest solution. So yeah, in terms of color, of course, you're also free to do whatever you want. But yeah, for me, I'm just going to do my lips now, and I'm going to do those in pink. So now that that's done, I'm going to do the final part, for which you can do, which you can use either eyelash glue or liquid latex. I'm going to use liquid latex because it's a bit more sticky. You can also use other adhesives like Prozade or Mastix, whatever works for you. But I only have liquid latex or eyelash glue, so I'm going for the latex. I'm going to glue this on my face, which I basically just drew some butterflies on cardboard. Painted them with acrylic paint, cut them out, and then with a glue gun I glued the wings to the body so they sit at an angle. I mean, it was quite a lot of work, and I think for me it actually turned out quite well considering I'm absolutely horrible at crafting as usually. But it will probably be much easier to just use store-bought ones, but I didn't have any, so this was my solution. I have a zit right here, so that's going to have a butterfly on it. Why am I not surprised that I now have liquid latex on my floor? I do recommend, if you actually are going to like a fantasy event with this sort of thing, to either use a very strong skin adhesive or to just put them on your forehead where you won't be moving your face while talking. Just because I don't think this is going to last very long. Okay, and then when finally the latex will be dry, we're done. And that leaves us with the final results. I really hope you enjoyed watching this video, and that it might have been useful if for some reason you want to glue butterflies to your face as well. But yeah, at any rate, the products I used are down below in the description box. If you want to do this look as well and don't have the same products, but similar stuff, you can do it as well, of course. You don't need the exact same products I used. Other than that, if you did enjoy this video, please click the like button. It would really help me out. And if you want to see more of my makeup escapades, you can always subscribe to my channel if you'd like. And yeah, that was it for today. Thank you very much for watching. I hope you have a wonderful day, and I hope to see you next time. Bye!